Many times in physics, we want to compare two values. We use the T prime concept to do this. Where does the formula come from? It's important to remember that our two values will have uncertainties associated with them, so we'll have A plus or minus delta A and B plus or minus delta B. To know if A and B are the same or different, we need to subtract one from the other and then compare the result to the uncertainty in the difference. The top of the T prime ratio is the subtraction, and the bottom is the associated uncertainty. Remember that uncertainties add in quadrature for addition and subtraction. That's why the denominator looks like the Pythagorean theorem. Let's look at an example. I got to fly on NASA's SOFIA, an infrared telescope mounted on a 747. In addition to observing the telescope's scientific mission, my teammates and I were allowed to run our own experiments. Knowing that gravity weakens with height, and that the period of a pendulum depends upon gravity, we wanted to see if we could measure the difference between a ground level period and one at an altitude of 12 kilometers. Here we have the raw data. What we want to do is we want to be able to get this into the form where we can compare the ground period to the flight period. So we're going to need to know what the mean is and the standard error for each measurement, because the standard error is what we use for our uncertainty. So to do that, we would go to Data, and we go to Data Analysis, and we would pick Descriptive Statistics. I would pick an input range here and hit OK. And what that would give me is the mean and the standard error. So I'm going to take the mean, I'm going to copy that over to right there, and take the standard error and copy that back over there. So that's giving me the numbers for the mean and the standard error on the ground period. Now I can go back to data and repeat the process for the flight. I'm going to grab that. I'm going to say OK. Now I've got a different mean and I'm going to have a different standard error. Now the first thing I want to know is going to be A minus B. So for that I'm going to have this guy minus this guy. So I'm going to get that right there. Then I want to know the uncertainty. And here I'm going to have to use a square root. I'm going to take this guy, raise him to the second power, and I'm going to add in this guy, raised to the second power. Then I'm going to want to know what T prime is, and that's going to equal A minus B divided by my uncertainty, and I get 0.875. What do I do with that? Once we have T prime, we can reference this table. In this case, T prime is less than 1. That means that the measurements are unlikely to be different, but we may have overestimated our uncertainty. Note in this example, the uncertainty in the flight measurement alone was more than the difference between the two periods, so just by eyeballing, we could have made the same claim. And also note that as a follow-up, it is suggested that we try to reduce the uncertainty in our measurements. Now looking at this, it seems like we've got a lot more uncertainty in this measurement than we do in the first measurement. I think some of this is because when we're in flight, we've got a lot more vibrations of the airplane. The engines are running. So suppose we could do something crazy. Suppose we could talk to NASA and hang our pendulum off of their gyroscopically stabilized telescope. No, they would not let you do this. But if they did, maybe we could take more data, have less vibrations, and drastically reduce our uncertainty here. So instead of having 0.0054, maybe we could get 0.001. And again, maybe we could take some precautions on this other measurement and also reduce our uncertainty. Now, if we took more measurements, certainly we would not get the same means, because when you take different measurements, the means are going to be different with your results. That's sort of built into the whole idea of uncertainty. You're not going to get the same mean every time. But suppose A minus B was still roughly 0.005, and we had these much smaller uncertainties on our measurements. If we did that, then we would find that our uncertainty would equal this. And that's not too surprising. That's what you get when you add 1 squared plus 1 squared, get the square root. That's 1.41. And now we look and we say, hey, T prime, that's about 3.5. And a T prime of 3.5 is telling you something very different than a T prime that's less than 1 or between 1 and 3. In this case, the difference between the measured values is much larger than the associated uncertainty, and we can now claim that the two results are likely different. This isn't a universal result. If the two values really were the same, then we would expect the difference to shrink as the uncertainties shrunk and for T prime to stay below 1. I hope that you have enjoyed learning about how to calculate and interpret T prime.